courtesy of The Verge. This is news courtesy of The Verge. Pretty cool news, actually. This is up close and personal with the Ford F-150 Lightning electric pickup truck. So I think, what was it? Was it last year? Yeah, last year, Tesla announced a Cybertruck that's due to come out next year, 2022. I think it was going to start production this year, but they're probably going to start production next year. There's been some delays, obviously, due to COVID and due to, I don't think they were able to set up the, or is it the Giga Berlin? I think so. I think it's a manufacturing warehouse in Berlin that's going to make the Cybertruck. But either way, there's been delays, there's been pushback. But because of the Cybertruck, I found out a lot of stuff about the Ford F-150 and how it's the most, you know, it's the most well-sold car. But is that the right term? I think it's the right term. In the US, I think from the time of writing, it's close to a million F-150s were sold last year. And if you're just listening to the podcast, an F-150 is basically a pickup truck, a very popular Ford model that's, you know, you always see them featured in loads of American TV shows and whatever it may be. And I guess people just use them as an, I guess it's the American version of like a white van, it feels like, because it's quite multi-purpose. It's got the flatbed at the back that can be covered. Usually most of them are kind of six-seaters, so you can, you know, have a lot of people jumping in them and whatever it may be, towing capability, all that good stuff. So it's a basically a US version of a white van, man, without being, you know, a van, it's essentially. And it feels like, obviously, with Tesla introducing the Cybertruck, Ford felt a bit of pressure, which is surprising, because it feels like some of the bigger car manufacturers, you know, electric cars are a bit of an afterthought. But they definitely saw that, you know, especially with the burgeoning market and with the Cybertruck being, you know, as amazing as it is, they wanted to capitalize on that, what would you call it, brand loyalty that they already have with people that love the F-150, and just make a lightning version of it. And they've done it. So they've made an electric version of F-150, and it looks pretty similar to the regular F-150. They've kind of changed the grill. It's got this kind of plasticky jacket thing at the front with no air vents, because obviously there's no engine there. And then the lights have been changed at the front, so it's kind of like this bar that goes around it. That's pretty cool. There's some branding, I think, around it too. Obviously out here that says Lightning. There's, I think, a lightning thing at the back of the pickup truck. Next to the flag is a little lightning bolt. Some tweaks here and there, mostly interior, but apart from that, it looks like a pretty standard F-150, but it's entirely electric, so that's pretty cool, isn't it? So this is courtesy of The Verge. It says, at first glance, a giant pickup truck parked in the middle of the pedestrian path along the Hudson River Greenway was indistinguishable this way from other service vehicles. After all, it was just another F-150, the most popular pickup truck and the most popular vehicle in the US. But a closer look would reveal some key differences. The full width light bar in the front and the rear vehicle, the giant front trunk or frunk, and the lightning badge on the rear corner of the trunk. It was less than a week since the big debut at Debon, and the all-new F-150 Lightning, the automaker's first electric pickup truck, was making a quick appearance in Manhattan, before heading back home. One of the first things you'll notice about the F-150 Lightning is how big it is. It's not surprising given how huge trucks are in the US have been getting over the several decades. But while the F-150 Lightning is roughly the same size as a fossil fuel equivalent, it weighs 6,500 pounds or more than 35% more than a gas version. So there's a lot of weight on there, isn't it? And again, it's probably going to be low center of gravity, of course, because of all the batteries being right at the bottom of the chassis itself. That's in large part thanks to the 1,800-pound battery resting immovably in the floor of the trunk. So it's a huge beast. It's just interesting that pickup trucks aren't that popular in the UK. It makes sense anyway, because most of them are pretty big. They're not exactly the best things to drive on, you know, UK streets. You probably can't find a lot of parking that's going to make it, you know, manageable for somebody, especially if you're a handyman or craft, whatever, you work with your hands outdoors and stuff. It's just not really functional to be able to drive a car that you can't park in most places, and that you have to kind of walk far distances to get to where you're going to actually do your work. So that doesn't make any sense, but they are quite functional, isn't it? More than quite functional, they're very, very functional. It says here, depending on the configuration, that battery will power The F-150 Lightning for 230 to 300 miles of range in a single charge. It also helped to load loads of truck stuff like the fueling and towing and off-roading. The electric version of the F-150 does not lack its truckness. It has lots of quirks and features that will keep you fans from among that will find its fans among the millions of current F-150 owners, such as the extra step that extends out at the back of the tailgate to help with climbing onto the bed, or the ridiculous number of power outlets that can be found all over the truck. The bed also serves as a scale that can help factor in the weight of whatever cargo is being carried to see how it would adversely affect the truck's overall range. But what an amazing thing, isn't it? Like, look at the unintended consequences of Tesla announcing the Cybertruck, right? Now an entire sector of automakers has decided, you know what, we need to kind of compete, we need to make sure that we're kind of throwing our hat in a ring. And one of the kind of, again, biggest car manufacturers and one of the popular ranges of pickup trucks decided to directly answer that by making their own. And now we have a great, you know, bit of competition for the customer. And ultimately, this is the best thing, because the customer always wins off the back of this. Because what it means is that Tesla and Ford are going to be pushing each other in any way, shape or form to provide as much value as they can for their customer. And again, we're going to be in a far better future, because ultimately we're going to move away from fossil fuels and into some more sustainable things like electric powered cars. And there's nothing better than seeing people that actually work day to day and, you know, have to, you know, manage and whatever it may be, being able to use these cars and also be somewhat environmentally friendly. That's flipping amazing to see, to be completely honest. There's some pictures here of the front storage compartment. I'll see some pictures here on the side. It looks really nice, to be honest. I would love to drive one of those in the UK, but again, like I said, the UK streets are not probably functional for a massive pickup truck such as these. But I'm sure there are a couple of YouTubers out there that have that kind of, you know, have a love for the Americana side of things, that decided to get a pickup truck and drive them in the UK streets. It's probably not the smartest thing to do, especially if you live in a very densely populated residential area, a metropolitan city like I do here in London. But, you know, I guess it can be a bit fun to have this hurtling down the street somewhere in the M55. You know what I mean? I'd say the M25 overtaking, you know, randoms would be super sick. Super quiet, you know, just hurling down the street. But it looks really, really cool. It looks incredible, to be fair. So I'm really eager, anticipating to see obviously the next couple of iterations of the F-150 Lightning, and then of course once the Cybertruck comes out, I'm also interested to see how people use it day to day. I think most people will just end up using it just as a car to flex with. I don't know, maybe I'm being too pessimistic. I don't think it's gonna be a lot of kind of, you know, workers day to day that are going to switch from an F-150 to a Cybertruck. It doesn't necessarily feel like that's going to be a thing, especially with the Lightning that's just been introduced. I think most people that are going to buy the Cybertruck are just going to buy it because it's an interesting looking car, or they just like what it looks like. Do you know what I mean? Not really using it for their day to day work, whatever it may be. But yeah, Ford F-150 Lightning, I guess it's going to be out soon. I think when I last saw pre-orders, I was like at the 70,000 mark, which is pretty decent considering all things considered, especially again with the competition that exists out there with the bloody Tesla Cybertruck in it. That makes complete sense.